There's a growing debate over the use of corn as fuel.
Especially as the price of corn continues to skyrocket. News Channel 8's Angie Hunt explains.
Iowa's ethanol plants have already cut production by as much as 20% to 30% due to the rising cost of corn. Iowa State economist Chad Hart says the bottom line influences production decisions more than any federal mandate.
It's the economics that are driving this. Companies aren't making money on the ethanol right now. They're backing away from corn. If they were making money right now, they would continue to use the corn.
Corn prices are expected to climb even higher due to the dry and withering crop. And that's why livestock producers are calling on Congress to change the ethanol mandate to lessen the demand for corn. But Iowa Senator Charles Grassley says it should not be up to corn producers to subsidize costs for livestock farmers.
They want $3 corn again. And they had it for so many years, they're used to it, and it's hard to get over the fact that maybe it's okay for a corn farmer to make a profit.
Hart says ethanol producers have already blended half the required 13.2 billion gallons for this year. So a change to the mandate would have little effect in the short term. Plus, producers have responded to the higher demand by planting more acres.
We would not have planted 96 million acres of corn this year if we had not had an ethanol industry.
Ultimately, Hart says we could see an impact in prices at the pump. Drivers we talk to don't like the idea of paying more for gas or food because of higher corn prices, but they're not sure cutting corn as a fuel alternative is a good idea.
I think we need to explore other options other than corn, but the reality of it is we just need so much of it that it's tough to find a better solution.
In Story County, Angie Hunt, KCCI News Channel 8, Iowa's news leader.